Hallelujah. Praise God. Welcome back to the time of relief, the time of revelation, the time of liberation, the time of empowerment, and the time of favor. Today we are treating a topic I titled The Love of Money. This popular saying, "The love of money is the root of all evil," was uttered by Apostle Paul in 1 Timothy chapter 6 verse 10. We will see how this scripture plays out in the life of two of God's servants, Pastors Joel and Abia Samuel, the sons of highly revered prophet Samuel. Unlike their venerable father, they woefully failed, not trailing his steps. They were corrupted by the love of money. I've had many people, unfortunately, even at times, ministers mock this godly counsel of a father, Paul, to his spiritual son, Timothy, and by the extension to all Christian ministers. I want to emphasize this. The love of money is not a bad thing. Within the realm that God designed it to operate, the realm of the secular business, the realm of trade and commerce, God gives power to make money. But in the realm of kingdom business, in the realm of soul saving, the love of money is the root of all evil, because the profit of this other business is not in money or wealth, but in souls saved and the spiritual essences added to them. Paul told Timothy, "Contentment is the rule for ministry success." When Paul said this, he wasn't talking to businessmen, traders, or someone in the commerce industry. That instruction then would be a misnomer, but he was talking to a minister of the gospel. That same Jesus told the 12, "Whatsoever is set before you, eat." Therefore, for a Christian business person doing secular business, what the Lord Jesus said, "Freely you received, freely you give," do not apply. He or she bought the merchandise and asked to gain money back. When the Lord said, "Whatsoever is given to you, that you should accept," he wasn't talking to people in secular business. Doing that guarantees business failure. There lies the problem with many of us. Shortchanging God's love for trade and commerce for God's love for the spiritual business of soul saving, or vice versa. That leads to demise of either. Pastors Abel and Abia thought that their father Samuel was old-fashioned. They didn't learn in the ways of the world. They thought it was out of tune with the modern practices of business dealings. They had their first class in business administration, management, banking and finance, in all relevant business courses in the college. So they imported that secular revenue generating business ideas into the church management and administration. Of course, they made money, but God, their judgment perverted, the perverted judgment starts taking bribes. I've heard a minister said, "Every meeting held must generate the money used in hosting it and the money for the minister's pocket." Such was the mindset of these young men. It short-circuited their ministry, destroyed the legacy their spiritual father painstakingly built over the years. So Paul told his spiritual son, Timothy, "Gain is not godliness." Ministry is not a source of financial profit, a money-making business, a means of livelihood, a means of financial gain. When God's servant in the secular business smuggles into the spiritual business, the secular business laws of profit-making, as did Pastors Abel and Abia, he or she is being driven by the love of money, and shall eventually be disgraced, fall into temptation, snare, many foolish things and harmful desires which plunge men into ruin and destruction. The love of money is wrong motivator for ministerial endeavors. It ruined Prophet Balak, destroyed leader Achan, devastated Minister Gehazi, and perished Apostle Judas. Any of God's servants with insatiable crave for money is a disaster waiting to happen. 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 10. For the love of money is the root of all kinds of evil. And some people craving for money have wandered from the true faith and pierced themselves with many sorrows.